physics, Trev. So in the previous video, we just introduced radioactivity. We looked at the terms which are involved. Now today, I'm going to move a step further by looking into details, knowing the properties of these particles that are involved in radioactivity. Now, the most important thing that we're going to start with is the sources of these three-watt particles. You're supposed to know at least an example of a source for alpha, beta, and what? A gamma. It's very much important because in an exam, you'll be asked to cite an example or a source for alpha, a source for beta, and a source for a gamma. So we'll start with an alpha particle. So, alpha particle, what element or mineral can emit what? Alpha particle. So for the alpha particle, the source is americium 241. Then number two, we can go to a beta particle. So for the beta particle is strontium 90. That's for the beta particle. Then number three, we have the gamma. So for the gamma ray, the source is cobalt 60. So these are the sources for these three-watt particles. So it's very much important that you understand these are sources. And if you are asked in an exam to cite an example for alpha, the source is americium 241, then beta is strontium 90, then gamma is cobalt what? 60. Then from there, we are going to move to deflection of alpha, beta, and gamma in the electric field and also in a magnetic field. How do these particles behave when it comes to electric field or a magnetic field? It's very much important that you understand the way they behave. Now, when it comes to these three particles that we have there, we have the beta particle, we have the alpha particle, and also we have the gamma ray. So again, we know that, let me just put them there, so we know that alpha is positively charged, then the beta is negatively charged, then gamma, it is neutral, it has got no charge. So based on this information, it is going to help us to understand the way these particles behave when it comes to these fields. Now, we start with the electric field. So the source for the radioactive particles. Then when they enter this field, how do they behave? How are they going to be deflected? That's what is important to take note there. So we'll start with the beta particle. So you know that the beta particle is negatively charged. And when it comes to the electric field, we have two charges, which is the positive and the negative charge. So there we have the positive plate, then down there we have the negative plate. Now, how is the beta particle going to behave in this electrical field? We know that the beta particle is negatively charged. So the moment it enters the electric field, it is going to deflect to the positive charge. So this is where it's going to go because it's what? Negatively charged. So it will go to the positive plate there. There will be a force of what? Attraction. Then when it comes to the alpha, we know that alpha is positively charged. So alpha, it cannot go to the positive charge because it's what? Positively charged. So it will be deflected to the negative charge. So it will go to the negative plate there. So there will be attraction, positive and negative. So that's what you're supposed to know there. Then for the gamma, it will just continue to go in a straight party line. It is never affected by the electric party field. It cannot be affected. So it will just go straight. It is neutral. It has got no charge. That's the reason why it's just going straight like that. It is not deflected. Then because of this reasoning, we know that it will just continue going at it straight. It has got no mass. These alpha and beta, they are referred to as particles. But take note, that's why you're using a ray. There we're using a particle. There we're using what? A particle. But for gamma, we're using what? A ray. We know that a particle is just something that has got a mass. Anything that has got a mass is called a particle. But for the gamma, we are using what? A ray. And anything that has got mass, it is supposed to be affected by electric field. But gamma is not what? Affected. That's why we are saying this is what? It is a neutral. Then again, it shows that it has got no mass. The mass for gamma is what? Zero. It has got no mass. It cannot be deflected in an electric field. So it's very much important to understand that. Then the next one, we are moving to a magnetic field. So how do they behave in a magnetic field? So we have the source there, and we have alpha, we have gamma, then you have the beta particle. So if you try to compare the masses, for alpha, it has the largest what? Mass. Then beta, it has the lowest, or let me say the lowest mass. Let me not say the lowest. Then gamma, the mass for gamma is what? It's a zero. It has got no mass. It cannot be affected by a magnetic field or electric field. That's why the gamma, we know this is electromagnetic in nature, which means that it can never be affected by a magnetic or electric field. It can never be affected. So you have to take note there. So this one, it has got the largest what, mass. Then, as if you are comparing the two, beta and alpha, this one has a larger mass as compared to a beta particle. So when they are coming, when they enter into the field there, magnetic field, you find that beta is going to be deflected the most. It is going to be deflected the most. Then there we have alpha. Alpha, it will continue to go, then it will do what? Deflect. Which shows that this one contains a larger mass as compared to this one. Then this one just continue to move in a straight what? Line, because it can never be affected by a magnetic field. Okay, so we're still looking at some properties of these three particles that we are talking about. So we come to the penetrating powers. So it comes to the penetrating powers, or the ability of a substance to pass through. That's what we are talking about here. So it comes to, if this is the source, okay, this is the source, then it comes to alpha, we know that alpha, it has the weakest or the lowest penetrating power. It cannot pass through a piece of paper. Even just on a skin there, it cannot penetrate. So it means that it has the lowest penetrating power. It can be blocked just by a piece of what? Paper. That's what it means there. Then, beta, it is going to pass through what? A piece of paper, but it can be blocked by what? Aluminium material. So it cannot go through what? Aluminium. It will be blocked. Then when it comes to the gamma, gamma will go through the paper, aluminium, but it cannot go through what? Lead. So this shows that if you are trying to keep a radioactive substance, the best material that you can use is a lead. It cannot penetrate. Then, when it comes to, if you compare this one, so you're saying beta and gamma. Beta, it has a medium penetrating power. This one, the lowest. Lowest, the medium. When it comes to gamma, it is the highest there. So what does this mean? The one with the lowest penetrating power, it means that it has got the highest what? Ionization power. Then the one with the highest penetrating power, it means that it has the lowest ionization power. Which means that alpha, outside there, it has got no effect. But the moment it enters inside the body, it can affect all the organs which are in our bodies. So because it has the highest what? Ionization power, then the lowest what? Penetrating power. So it's very much, you understand the way they are supposed to penetrate there. Okay, so I've summarized the properties or characteristics of these radioactive particles in the table
So we have radioactive emissions. They are going in this direction. So alpha, beta, and gamma, very clear. Then the symbol, we have the nature, then the charge, then ionization power, then penetrating power.
Now, it's very much important. These are the properties of these particles and the red there. So in an exam, they'll ask you to state the properties of alpha, the properties of beta, and also the properties of the gamma. So these, you state the properties in terms of these. So the first one, the alpha there, we know that the symbol, this is the symbol, and this is alpha, then this is beta, then this is the gamma. Then the nature, we know that the nature for alpha is what? Helium nucleus, which is He. Then the nature for beta is what? A fast moving what? Electron. Then for this one, it is electromagnetic, meaning that it cannot be affected by electric fields or magnetic fields. That's what it means there. Then the charge. What is the charge for alpha? We know it's positive 2. It is a positive duality charge. It's positive 2. Then the beta particle is a negative 1. That's the charge for the beta particle. Then the gamma we know is a neutral, which is just a 0. It has got no charge. Then ionization power. For the ionization power, we have alpha. So we're saying that alpha, it has the lowest penetrating power. So it contains the strongest ionization power. Then for the beta particle, we know it's medium or intermediate. The ionization power is medium or intermediate. Then for the gamma, it is what? The weakest. It has got the weakest ionization power. Then penetrating power there, we know that alpha, it has the lowest, meaning it's supposed to have the strongest what? Ionization power. Then for the beta, it's always medium, 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 intermediate, intermediate. Then since it has got the weakest ionization power, it means it has got the highest what? Penetrating power. Then the chapter continues there. So we've talked about these are two fields, electric and magnetic fields. So we're saying that for the alpha, how does it behave when it comes to an electric field? So it bends towards the negative plate there because it's positively charged. So it will go to the negative plate. This one, it is a negatively charged, it will go to the positive plate. Then for the gamma, we know that gamma, it is a neutral, it has got no charge. It is just a neutral to continue to move in a straight line. Then when it comes to the magnetic field, so I've just summarized these points there. You can just go through. We know that for the alpha, it bends a little, showing that it has a bigger mass. Then this one bends what? A lot, showing that it has a smaller mass as compared to alpha. Then this one does not bend. It will continue to move in a straight line, which shows that it is not a particle. The mass for a gamma, we know is zero. So it is not considered to be a particle. A particle is something that has got mass. Then when it comes to mass, alpha, it has the highest mass or the largest mass. Then for the beta, it has a lower mass. When you are trying to compare the two, this one has more mass as compared to the beta. Then for the gamma, it has got no mass. That's why it can never be affected by electric and magnetic fields. So I expect you to go through and make sure you understand all these properties. If I give you a question to state the properties of alpha, beta, or gamma, you must be able to state all these properties that we have summarized in the table. So for today, this is where we are going to end. And take care of yourselves. Thank you.